Okay, so I figured it out, and I feel like an idiot. You just keep running away from her while you're red. Come back here, you little punk! No. See you, Undine. Welcome to Hotland Ring. Hey, what's up? I was just thinking, you, me, and Undine should all hang out sometime. I think you would make great pals. Let's meet up at her house later. Click. Now is not the time. Welcome to Hotland. Leave me alone! Piss off! Sans, help! Sans! Sans, I require assistance! Come back here, you little punk! No. Sans, why are you sleeping? Now is not the time to be sleeping, Sans! Armor, so hot. But I can't give up! Sorry, Undyne. It's a water cooler. Take a cup of water? Yes, you take a cup of water. Give Undyne the water? Fuck yeah! We're gonna be the best of friends. Eh. How you doing, Undyne? I'm here to be your friend. Okay, see you, Undyne. Good talking at you. I'm gonna go back and hang out with Sans real quick. No, I'm not. He's gone. What are you? What? Nothing. You're not telling me anything. Okay, never mind. Welcome to Hotland. Maybe if I go back and hang out with Undyne? Can I go back and talk to her? I'm definitely gonna go back and save. Hello, ice cubes. Giant ass ice cube river. The howling wind is now a breeze. This gives you determination. There we go. That's how we're going. We're leaving. We're leaving this place behind. Because if your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they ain't no friends of mine. Heyo. Excuse me. Welcome to Hotland. I mean, that's appropriate. Considering it's a giant magma lake. What the shit are you? Oh, KKKKKKKKK, I was thirsty, so I came over from Waterfall to get a drink. You are a clam. It's a water cooler. Take a cup of water? Yes, you take a cup of water. Wait, are you just carrying that around to look sophisticated? Because it's not working. I'm going to carry it with me. The water evaporated from the heat. Damn, the cup evaporated too. Holy shit, it's hot here. Seeing such a strange laboratory in a place like this, you're filled with determination! Laboratory entrance. Sorry, Undyne, like, told us there was totally a human in the area, so, like, us royal guards are blocking off the elevators for now. Nyah! Even if the elevators aren't working anyway, we'll do our best, Miss Undyne. And he says nothing. Excellent. That's not terrifying in the slightest. What's down here? Tra-la-la, I am the river man, or am I the river woman? It doesn't really matter. I love to ride in my boat. Would you care to join me? Ride in the boat? Where are we going? Where will we go today? Never mind. We're going to go to Snowden. Then we're off. Why do you look like the Grim Reaper? I know it's supposed to be on the River Styx, but... Come on. Tra-la-la, the piano plays the tinkling song. Tinkling. Excuse me. Oh, cool. This is where we stop. Can I go back? I want to go back. Come again sometime. Tra-la-la. Tra-la-la. Care for a ride? Ride in the boat? Yes. Where will we go? To Hotland. Then we're off. And away we go for another magical ride. Shouldn't we be going upriver? Tra-la-la. Temi Village. The room before the darkening lantern room. Wait, what? I have to go find that off-screen. I'll go find Temi Village off-screen. It's going to be awesome. Or off-camera. Come again sometime. Okay, so we're going to go into the lab. Ooh. That's not terrifying at all. It's you? It's too dark to see near the walls. It's too dark to see near the walls. It's too... Okay, fine. Everything's just too dark. Hello! Who are you? Meh! Oh my god! I didn't expect you to show up so soon. I haven't showered, I'm barely dressed, it's all messy, and... I gotta sneeze. Excuse me, hiya! I'm Dr. Alphys, Asgore's royal scientist. But I'm not one of the bad guys. Actually, since you stepped out of the ruins, I've, been observing your journey through my console. Your fights, your friendships, everything. I was originally going to stop you, but watching someone on screen really makes you root for them. So, now I want to help you. Using my knowledge, I can easily guide you through Hotland. I know a way right to Asgore's castle, no problem. Well, actually, there's just a tiny issue. A long time ago, I made a robot named Metaton. Originally, I built him to be an entertainment robot. You know, like a robotic TV star or something. Anyway, I recently decided to make him more useful. You know, just some small practical adjustments, like, anti-human combat features. Of course, when I saw you coming, I immediately decided I have to remove those features. Unfortunately, I may have made a teensy mistake while doing so, and, now he's an unstoppable killing machine with a thirst for human blood? But, hopefully we won't run into him. 3, 2, 1. Oh, did you hear something? Oh no. Oh no. Oh yes! Welcome, beauties! To today's quiz show! Game show! Oh boy, I can already tell it's gonna be a great show! Everyone give a big hand for our wonderful contestant! Never played before, gorgeous? No problem, it's simple! There's only one rule! Answer correctly! Or you die! Metaton attacks! I like the music. Check. Metaton, attack 30, defense 255. His metal body renders him invulnerable to attack. Let's start with an easy one! What's the answer for what's the prize for answering correctly? More questions! Right, sounds like you get it! Quiz show continues! Metaton. Check. Here's your terrific prize! What's the king's full name? Asgore Dreamer. Correct! What a terrific answer! Scream is against the rules. Enough about you, let's talk about me! What are robots made of? Metal and magic? Too easy for you, huh? Quiz show continues. Metaton. Here's another easy one for you. Oh god. Oh, D. Thank you for that, Alphys. Wonderful! I'm astounded, folks! The quiz show continues. Don't count on your victory! How many flies are in this jar? Oh, thanks, Alphys. Correct! You are so lucky today. Not just luck. Metaton. His metal body renders him immune to attack. Let's play a memory game! What monster is this? It's Froggit. Oh, shit. Boy, that's embarrassing, huh? The quiz show continues. But can you get this one? Would you smooch a ghost? Heck yeah. Great answer, I love it! The quiz show continues. Here's a simple one. How many letters in the name Metaton? Holy shit. Of course, that was easy for you! I love you, Metaton. I understand why all my friends have an obsession with you. Time to break out the big guns! In the dating simulation video game, Mew Mew Kissy Cutie, what is Mew Mew's favorite food? Alphys! 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 You aren't helping our contestant, are you? Oh, you should have told me! I'll ask a question! You'll be sure to know the answer to! Who does Alphys have a crush on? I'm gonna say Undyne. See, Alphys, I told you it was obvious! Even the human figured it out! Yes, she scrawls her name in the margins of her notes! She names programming variables after her! She even writes stories of them together! Sharing a domestic life! Probability of crush, 101%! Margin of error, 1%! Well, well, well! With Dr. Alphys helping you, the show has no dramatic tension! We can't go on like this! But! This was just the pilot episode! Next up, more drama! More romance! More bloodshed! Until next time, darlings! See you, Metaton. Good talking at you. Oh god, he's got a rocket booster?
Well, that was certainly something.
It's a great exercise.
Wait! Let me give you my phone number. Then, maybe, if you need help, I could... Where'd you get that phone? It's ancient! It doesn't even have texting! Wait a second, please.
Excuse me. I like Metaton. Metaton's pretty badass.
Here, I upgraded it for you. It can do texting, items, it's got a keychain. Eddie, I even signed you up for the Underground's number one social network. Now we're officially friends! I'm going to the bathroom.
Okay, see ya, Alphys. The fridge is filled with instant noodles and soda. Take a package of noodles?
Hell yeah!
You got the instant noodles. It's a bag of dog food. It's half full. Is Alphys supposed to be a dog or a lizard? It's a beat-up figurine of a female human with cat ears. It's a computer. It's accessing some kind of puzzle in Snowden. Seems like the notes of to something, but it's all written in chicken scratch. It seems like a walkthrough to a game, or... a garbage can. But it's pretty cute. Can I go up this? Damn it! I can't go up the escalator that's going downward! Can I go through the wall, or the hole that Metaton made? The space behind the wall is only a few feet wide. Yellow feet are tapping just behind the door. Alphys, you are awkward and I love you. I don't want to be outside of the lab. I like it in here. The lab is cool. What's going on up here? Scientific books. They seem very dusty. All these books are labeled human history. Read one. You look inside a book. It's a comic of a giant robot fighting a beautiful alien princess. This doesn't strike you as very accurate? VHSs and DVDs of various cartoons. They are all labeled human history. All these... Let's read another one. It's a comic book. Two scantily clad chefs are flinging energy pancakes at each other. This doesn't strike you as very accurate. All these more history human books are human history books. Hideous android is running to school with toast in its mouth. Seems like it's late. Yeah, no, definitely not. Pink goop drips from this strange machine. This looks like the tubby custard machine. Looks like Alphys's work table. Seems dusty. Why is there a chainsaw on it? The wardrobe is full of dirty lab coats and a single clean dress. And there are letters for many monsters. Froggit, Snowy, Doggo, they're all unopened. An incredible invention. When not in use, this bed folds into an extremely easy to draw box. Ha! It's a promo poster for Metaton's TV premiere. On the flap it says, "Thank you for making my dreams come true." Okay, so I guess we go out the side exit. Gotcha. It's a bathroom sign. I want to go in the bathroom. Okay, fine. Don't let me go in the bathroom. So what are we going on? Alphys updated status. Just realized I didn't watch Undyne fight the human. Aww. Alphys. Oh, shit. I missed that. Ah, damn it. I have to go back and read it. I can't, though. For now, I gotta call up the human and guide them. Please stop sending me texts every 3 seconds. Ooh, I like this place. Oh, and a fight. Vulcan strolls in. Check. Vulcan. Mistakenly believes its lava can heal people.
You're hurt. I'll help.
I wasn't ready for the potaboos. Makes a smoke hoop and jumps through it. I don't want to hug this thing. I'm gonna encourage. You tell Vulcan it's doing a great job. His attacks become more extreme.
Does my best.
Oh god, no. Yep. That's about right. Shit. Whoops! Don't lose hope! Dexter, stay determined! No, I don't want to. But I'm gonna call this an episode. I don't really want to go back through the fight with Metaton. So, for those of you who are new, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe if you want to. But if not, then carry on your merry way. But for the rest of you ramblers, I'll catch you on the next video, which I'll be back here. Doing... hero things. But yeah, bye everybody, it's been a lot of fun!